Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to display all the prime numbers within a particular range or interval in Python. So let's get started. So the first thing, we'll be getting the lower range and the upper range, that is the starting and the ending range from the user. So let me just have two variables for that. Let LR be my lower range equal to int of input, enter lowest range, and we just have it as lower maybe, and let me just now copy this, just paste it, enter the upper range. You can have it as start and end, like whatever you want. I will name this as UR. And next thing, we will be having a if condition. All right, so let's just come here and I will put if our upper range is greater than our lower range, because this value should be low and this value should be high. Like it can't be the reverse way, all right? And the lower range, that is this lower value, should be greater than one, all right? This is like kind of optional. If you want, you can skip it, but I'm having this condition over here. So in the next line, we will be having a for loop that iterates from this lower range till the upper range. So it's going to be for, let me name it as num in range. It's going to be lower range, comma upper range plus one, because it is minus one for, basically it takes like that. So we'll be putting plus one for the upper range. Okay, that's fine. And inside this for loop, we will be having another for loop. All right, so just come here and it's going to be for I in range. And this for loop is going to iterate from two till this num, okay, this particular num which iterates from lower range to upper range. So it's going to be two comma num. All right. So let me just now once type the entire code, and later I will show you a demo how this basically works. And in the next line, we will be having a if statement, all right? If this number, all right, this particular number that is iterating from lower to upper range, modulus this particular I which iterates from 2 to this number, equality is 0, which means that the number is divisible by some value lesser than that. That means it isn't a prime number. So for that, we will just be breaking this particular for loop, this particular inner for loop, all right? So it's going to be just break. And what if the number isn't divisible by this I? So for that, we will be just printing the number with the help of a else condition, all right? So just come here. So this else condition will be for the inner for loop, okay? And this should be straight to this for loop. Yeah, that's fine. And I'll just have else. I'll just print it, all right? Print that particular number. So in Python, for loop can also have else condition, okay? For loop and while loop also have can else. So this else condition will be triggered only when this for loop has completed its iteration, all right? In this case, whenever our for loop breaks in the middle, this else condition won't be triggered. And whenever this break condition isn't triggered, this else condition will be triggered, because our for loop has completely successfully done its iteration. I hope that made sense. I think we are good now. So yeah, I think your bracket should come over here. All right. Yeah. Now I'll just run and show you. Later I'll be explaining with the help of demo. So let me just now run it. So it's asking me to enter the lower range. I will go with something as 40 and the upper range be as 80. So I'm getting 41, 43. These are all prime numbers. I guess you can just verify it. Yeah, these are basically prime numbers. So now let me explain you how this basically works. So I think we'll be getting the same result even though we have num double slash 2. I think that won't make a change. If you want more efficient way, you can just add this line over there. It's optional. So now let me explain you how this code works. So our input value was 40 and upper range was 80, right? So what happens is that first this conditions will be getting checked. 80 is greater than 40, so this is true, and our 40 is greater than 1, so this is also true. Then it goes inside this. So our num range, num iterates between 40 and 80, all right? So it's going to be 40 till 80 num. So at the first time, num will be equal to 40, and it will go here. Our num will be 40 mod i value will be 2 at first. 40 is divisible by 2, it automatically breaks, and then our num value becomes 41. 41, it just go here, 41 mod 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, it just goes on. But 41 is a prime number, so it just does not get broken over here. And this for loop iteration completely gets over. And because of that, this else condition is triggered. As I told you earlier, this else condition will be triggered only when for loop successfully completes its iteration without breaking. Okay, so that's the reason 41 gets printed. So same thing, 42, then num becomes 42, same process over here. 2, it's divisible by 2, breaks it, not, it does not get printed. Then 43, 43 is a prime number, so this will be getting completely iterated because of that else condition is triggered. So you can also have a flag, maybe a flag variable 0 or 1, or you can just set it over here as well. So that's it for this video. I hope you have found this video useful. I also done many other programming videos in Python, C, C++, Java, MySQL, Node.js, React.js, 3D animation using Blender. So do check other videos of my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.